What's up, everybody? Welcome to another Roberson video. I am joined by Chris.
What's going on, people? I swear to God, like, every time I be a guest appearance and whatnot, I feel like I'm always that Sonic guy that this is what we mainly talk about.
It's that Sonic
but
guy.
I don't care. Like, you know, it feels so humbling and good to, like, be back and actually be able to do this with you live. Like, what's going on with you, man?
I'm good, man. How are you doing?
You know, awful work. Just looking at Sonic Frontiers on my library, just waiting to be played. But you know, it's
sitting there just lingering, just staring at you. It's just like,
exactly. It's like, it's haunting me. His stupid fucking grin, dude. Like,
him fucking grinding on that rail, just grinning at me. I'm like, oh, you fuck. I want to play you so bad.
Oh, my
but
God,
we
dude. Three more days.
Three more days, man. Woo! I'm ready for it. And we haven't talked about Sonic Frontiers, and I'm looking through my videos right now. It's been, oh my God, how far do I gotta scroll? Because we did it at, here it is. It was December 11th, 2021. So almost a year since we've talked about Sonic the Hedgehog on the channel.
And look how far we've come.
I know, dude. Like just from that initial, you know, teaser trailer we got at Game Awards, and now we're here, bro. All that hype.
Oh, dude,
so excited. And like, I made a video in July, I think it was, when they were, IGN was showing off the first stuff. So it's been a while since I've talked about Frontiers in depth and watched the videos, because dude, like, I am just like, there's so many videos that's come out, like, have been coming out, that I just haven't sat down and made a video on each of them, because I wanted to do something all together. Just get it all out of the way right before the game comes out. And then you texted me, and I was like, sheesh.
Oh, absolutely. I think this was a very appropriate time since, like, the launch trailer came out.
Yes.
Like, so I thought this would be a more perfect opportunity to, like, get the band back together. Mm-hmm. And do this once again, this hoorah for Sonic Frontiers, because hoorah. Our little blue boy has been through the ringer than I've ever seen him before. So, yeah, this is going to be a real interesting conversation.
They had us, man, because when those first gameplay release videos came out by IGN, I was a little iffy, bro. I was definitely like, are they really going to throw Forces Part 2 at us? Like, I was a little scared.
Oh, yeah, completely. Absolutely. Like, I don't blame people for when they first saw IGN. And, like, I, for whatever reason, I don't know why. It's either, I'm thinking it's most likely with Sega. But they said that, okay, this is okay to show to the grand audience, like, what you've seen from, like, that first. And I'm like, okay. Now, for me personally, I didn't give it the amount of hate that it got. I can understand it, but I didn't, like, you know, be like, oh my God, this game is shit. Delay it. Oh my God, it's not coming out. Please don't let it come out this year. I was one of the few people that was like, I'm just going to wait and see, because I said there's no way in hell
I'm waiting any longer
that they're showing this. This has to be exactly, like, I'm just going to be like, okay, because I, in my back of my head, said this looks more like alpha footage than anything else, because I'm like, there's no way if their release date is this year and it's this, I'm pretty sure it's a new build. That's all my initial speculation was at the time. So, and then when the first impressions from that one guy, and shout out to that guy who's been doing the IGN covering for this game, I think he's been, I feel like he's been really fair with the game. Like, you know, he does have criticisms what I can agree with and whatnot, but overall, I think he's been doing, and I really hope it's still him when he does the review and nobody else, to be honest.
The thing, you know what, the thing I was not anticipating for this game was how much they were going to take it back to the roots of the 2000s. I was not expecting so much of that, and I'm so down for it.
Oh yeah, I was honestly, I didn't think like it was even like possible, to be honest, because of so far in this era that we've gotten for modern Sonic anyways. But it's just like you say, it did a whole 180 because I didn't know what to expect when this game was initially like announced and whatnot. We had speculations and whatnot when we had that first video like way back when, but from shoot, and we'll get to those in a minute, but just summaries from the direction of the game in terms of like its narrative, the characters themselves, the music overall.
Dude, that music.
Holy sh- dude. Oh my god.
That music, man. Like, that shit, it goes hard. That
it
is
really
like an
does.
Understatement. It really goes
like,
fucking
it
hard.
It doesn't do it justice, like, at all. Just, bro, I'm telling you. The thing is, I remember when they revealed Vandalize.
Yeah.
Like, Vandalize has been on my playlist for, like, since it's been released last month.
I love Vandalize. When I first heard Vandalize, I was like, why isn't this the main song? Because this shit slaps so
Thank you.
I thought that was the main song. And then they said it was like the end, and I was like, nah, come on, man. Like, this kind of
slaps. I know. Dude, that's peak shonen anime intro one-on-one, bro.
It really
For
is.
Real.
Like, it really goes, like, beyond what it needs to. And then... When they did the I'm Here, they only showed like a little bit of it, and so when I heard that, I was like, I don't know if this is main song worthy.
But, yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I think Vandalize kind of like freaking like spoiled me.
It really did. Like, I heard the full version of I'm Here. I've heard the full song now, and it does go fuck. It slaps hard now that I've heard the full thing. But I'm still on the fence. I don't know if I like it more than Vandalize. I know people in the comments were switching their thoughts on it, but
opinions.
I was like, yeah, their opinions. But I was like, I still think Vandalize is a little bit up. And then I heard there was another song that's in the game. Did you see that also?
I did. It's actually.
Is that the ending?
Don't worry.
Credits?
No.
Final fight or.
It's one of. Actually, it's funny because I heard. the first Titan boss soundtrack and whatnot and dude like it goes surprisingly really good and the thing is I stumble on it by accident and then like oh my god the vocals in it it's like it has this more of a not like what's that genre called it's like sort of like metal but then again, like they reel it back. Like,
yeah,
like it's not. It's like it has a good enough amount of like screaming or like, and then it reels back to the feminine vocals.
Yeah,
and I forgot her name. I'll have to look it up as we talk. But like, I think she did like a really like outstanding job with that. And I didn't even need to see the fight to just know like that was from like the first Titan.
Yeah,
and also like I don't know if you saw the that they released like the director of like the sound owned and like mix and whatnot on their official YouTube channel. I really liked that video because the guy was actually very wholesome and humbled and whatnot for working on these games for so long.
Yeah, dude, he's been doing
and
it
it's just
so
like,
long.
Yeah, so like, and where he started at, I feel like sorry, I almost burped. Where he actually started it at, like, you could tell that he brought some of that old element from his older music from like Adventure 2 for freaking like Heroes, freaking like Unleash and all this other stuff. He actually said Endless Possibility was his favorite song.
Oh,
and
yeah,
I said, my man.
Dude, that
my
is,
man.
That is one of my top songs from that series. It's Endless Possibility. I don't like the rap part of the song, but there is some edits where they take that part out and it's just the like flow of that. I love that song.
Mm-hmm.
It just flows so fucking good. And then did you see the one song? I got to look at it again. It's called One Way Dream.
Oh, that sounds like, if I'm not mistaken, isn't that one of It Wants the Battles tracks? Because they played it at the end of that video, didn't they?
I don't know. I just saw... today it was uploaded 2 days ago. It's part of the soundtrack. It's called One Way Dream. I listened to it and a lot of people say it's going to be this generation's Endless Possibility. That's what all the comments say. I can send it to you.
I'll have to take that listen just to see. I'll have to listen to that later on.
Well, you can listen to it right now, and I'll just edit to the part after you listen to it.
I would have to say it's not bad. It's of course, it's not bad. Like, not by any stretch of the imagination. Now, I'm not sure. Maybe it's the nostalgia thing or whatnot, but I'm not sure if that beats or it's equivalent to it Endless Possibility.
When I saw those comments, I personally didn't think it was. Personally, I didn't think it. Maybe it is just nostalgia. But I did think that he did capture that 2010, early 2010 feel in his song. So I thought that was really good. But obviously, I don't think that song tops Vandalize nor I'm Here. But I'm still down for it.
Yeah, I think if anything, of course. I think if I had to put a tier list, it'll be number 3, at least.
And that's not all the songs in the franchise. That's just for this game.
Yeah, exactly. And plus, there's still a lot more that we haven't listened to.
What did they say? They said that the soundtrack has like 100-something...
Yeah.
It's like a certain length. It's like hours or something.
Something like... Like, in itself, like, maybe like, it's a long soundtrack from stages to boss fights and all that good stuff.
They're saying it's like the longest soundtrack they've... in a Sonic game, so I'm like, alright, I'm down for it. I'm curious to see what songs are on this.
I mean, yeah, you guys already got me freaking buying the digital edition, so I'm expecting the digital soundtrack.
So, that's pretty much music out of the way. I think we can safely say that we're pretty stoked about the music. So, characters and the direction of this game. I love it. I love every piece of what's been coming out. Voice lines, Knuckles, all of it.
Yes, can we give a quick shout out to the man himself? My man, our Lord and Savior right now. At least that's what Twitter says and like, you know, everything above. Ian Flynn.
Yes.
Is the man.
Dude.
At this moment in time.
I cannot stress how happy I am to get rid of this fucking goofy ass shit. That we're finally going back to like the... more serious tone. If I had to hear Roger fucking sit there and crack fucking jokes for another minute, I think I would just throw the fucking console at the wall. Dude, it's like I'm playing a game for the story. Sometimes it's just for the gameplay. Generations is like that. I just like playing the gameplay. The story sucks, but you know, I'd like to have my
Generations have a story.
You can fucking call it that. Yeah, but. I'd like to have the story and good gameplay, and I think we might... I don't know about the gameplay per se, it looks good, but story-wise, I think I can confidently say I'd probably be coming out of this pretty happy.
Oh, yeah. Like, I'm really, really, like, happy that Sega decided to, like, finally just, again, take this man out from their back pocket. Like, this man has been like involved with these characters for at least a decade or so, give or take, like since Archie. And mind you, I haven't came from like the Archie comic books. I'm speaking more so fact of the recent work from the IDW series. Yeah. So what he's done in that series, like, really is getting translated very well into this game. Like,
I don't know why they didn't just pull these guys in the first place, you know. They had him there.
Exactly. But, like, I don't know exactly what goes behind the scenes with Sega when it comes to, like, when they hire and fire people. Yeah, it's mostly bullshit. We can all agree to that. Mm-hmm. So, like, freaking... Because off the first and, like, the trailer that we got from Gamescom this year, like, literally just seeing, like, the tone from Sage when Sonic is saving, like, that Coco... And then just Sage telling him to, like, basically stop, like, your actions endanger the world. And, like, him just pushing the cyber space portal. It's like, without him saying anything, like, and this is before he even sees Amy, that little detail, that just silent defiance that he has to him, it's just like, I was like, oh, shit. Like, it already kind of hooked me. And then when you hear Roger's voice for the very first time, I was like, oh. Just when he's like, Amy, is that you? And I was like, okay, that just tells me the script is like 1,000 times better than we got in recent memory. Seriously.
Yeah.
With that being said, like, I really feel like the narrative direction that they're going, because right now we still don't know exactly what's going on on. Like, this whole game is literally evidently shrouded in mystery. And yeah. like, it's kind of weird. Like, some people might not like that. And I know some people have complained about that because they don't know what they're getting into. But I think that's kind of the point.
And like, I'm very happy about that, too. Because, yeah, I was a little fucking pissed about the drought. But then, you know, if we got so much information at first, we would have been nitpicking every little fucking piece of it. At least when the game comes out, we'll play it. And then we can take it from there. But...
Absolutely. Yeah. Yep.
And plus, you know, it also helps for surprises. And I would like to play a game where the whole fucking story isn't thrown into my face in, like, the first three trailers of the game. So I'm glad that they've kind of done that drought.
Oh, yeah. Like, and guys, we understand, like, we get it that we're supposed to be, we're very hungry for more information, like, than we already gotten and whatnot. Exactly, starving. But, like, I think, like, we came, I guess me and you could both agree that we come to appreciate, like, what we've gotten, like, over, like, the coming months, like, since August, I would say.
Well, you know what I can say? I can say I'm very comfortable with it. You know, I'm very comfortable with how everything has come out, and I'm very, like, I'm not disappointed with it. I'm very okay with how things have gone out.
Mm-hmm. I would say so, too. Like, there'll be, like, it's like, I feel like I get, like, a thrill when some, like, when new information gets out, whether it's official or, like, leaked. More so official and whatnot, because it's actually coming from the mouths themselves.
Yes.
So, like, it's just, like, you know, it's like, all right, finally, what's next? What else can you tell me?
Yeah, dude. And
but don't. Oh, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I was gonna just go revert back to the characters and whatnot. Can we first say that animation short was fucking god tier?
I don't know why Sega has been jerking off these last couple years without giving us this shit, but I'm finally glad that they've done it, because this animation is amazing. It's fucking spectacular. It's not quite, you know, Sonic X. I know some people were like, Sonic X, but I was like, this is a little better than Sonic X. Like, I can't lie. This looks a lot cleaner.
Oh, yeah. I would think, and honestly, I was thinking in the back of my mind, like, man, like, I wish Sonic Prime looked like this, to be honest you.
Like, I like Prime's CGI. I like how smooth it is and how stretchy everything is. But there's something about that anime, you know, look to Sonic, and it works. I mean, it worked in X. It worked in Riders, that intro that they did for Sonic Riders. I mean, like...
Shout out to the Attack on Titan freaking studio made that shit, by the way.
Dude, like, it just meshes so well with that franchise. And CG, it kind of works, but I prefer to see it 2D animated. I think it looks better that way.
I think that's always been, like, a thing, though. Like, and that's always also been a talking point, like, when it comes to Sonic's animation and whatnot. Mm-hmm. Like, some people literally prefer the CGI. Some people prefer the 2D animation. Me, personally, I love the 2D, and I don't know why. Maybe it's because...
Well, you know what I miss? I miss the 2D artwork on the boxes and stuff, like, what they did with Adventure 2 and all that. I think that shit looked fucking awesome. But they wanted to do more CG renders, and I think the CG renders just look bland. I don't think they look very appealing.
Yeah, I would say in the more, like, I think that trend really started more so with
Heroes.
Yeah, actually Heroes and whatnot, and then they kind of move onward to Shadow the Hedgehog, and then Sonic 06, and, like, you know, they kind of just had that staple and whatnot, so... And we kind of just got accustomed to it.
I think Mania was the first time in, like, years they did 2D artwork on
box.
I think the DS was, like, the era that they were doing it in, and then they stopped. And then Mania came out and they redid it. But I know Frontiers is doing a CG box art thing, which, you know, it's whatever. I'm not going to complain about that. But I would prefer it to be 2D. I think that would look more appealing. Like, imagine you're in the store, you're looking at the games, you know, what's gonna catch your eye more, a CG render or a fucking awesome artwork by somebody?
Oh yeah, absolutely. And no, this is not disrespect to the artists who makes these, like, bot sets and whatnot. That's, it's like, just like, it's a more of a preference thing.
Yeah,
Yeah, it's more of a preference thing than anything else.
But yeah, there's people who like the CGR work, and I'm not gonna like diss you for liking it. It's again personal kind of thing, but 2D stuff, I think 2D just meshes with this franchise more. But the CG animation in the games, I love the CG animation in the games. What's the studio called who does that? It's like Mazda or something.
Yeah, and the people who made the Knuckles animation was Powerhouse.
Powerhouse did that one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, I loved the Knuckles one, and with the character, the new voice and stuff. I know they brought him in for Team Sonic Racing, but he sounded stupid.
Yeah, I was like, I'm not gonna lie, like I totally forgot that Knuckles' voice had changed after Forces, which I wasn't expecting.
It caught me off guard.
But it really did. Like, a little bit. Not too much. A little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I think he did well for what he was given.
Yes.
Like, I think he did, like, really capture...
I know what they were trying to give him. You know, that, like, goofy-ass, mm-hmm. fucking dumb Knuckles thing. So, I don't blame him for that, because he definitely made up for it here.
Yeah, and touching on, like, Knuckles' character and whatnot, I think... Ink, which I really appreciate, they really kind of went back to their roots.
Yes.
I think they did like a more of not a revamp, but more of a reintroduction of to Knuckles, of like who he is. For like Knuckles, primarily in the game and whatnot, we all know his sole purpose is to guard the Master Emerald. Like, and he's stoic. He can be hard-headed sometimes, but like, you know, he's compassionate. He's like, you know, he's an introverted character. He likes doing things by himself. Like, that's what the whole opening monologue was really about, just kind of like telling you who he is and like, you know, the way he likes to do things. And like, there's little scenes of like, you know, of that leaked out like throughout that animation, like when he mm-hmm. sees a child like, you know, trying to grab that little fruit off the tree, just punches in, just drops. Or like the other child when he's trying to grab that cocoa mask, which I find really adorable, he just literally just punched the wall, accidentally like hurting it and just giving him the mask and whatnot. So like stuff like that, it really, just like kind of little things just helps.
Yeah, but no, I was gonna say, like, yeah, it really just brings that character together, just seeing those little actions. You know, he doesn't have to say it, he shows it.
Yes, and like, I appreciate like freaking Tyson Hesk for like, you know, the direction that he mm-hmm. wanted to take this. Obviously, like, you know, Ian Flynn was writing the script. Evan Stanley had a hand in it. I love her work, honestly. Yeah. I think she's great. And also, we really see Knuckles throw so much fucking hands as soon as he gets to the fucking Starfall Islands, dude.
Those fight scenes, dude. Fucking fire.
Yeah, shout out to the animators who made that shit, because I was really shocked that we actually got a fight scene, and I was pleasantly surprised by it.
I
thought they were gonna do a stupid cut to black. No, dead ass, I thought it.
I know what you mean, because Sega, you know, that's how some of their shit goes, but I was pleasantly surprised that they went full force with it, and it felt really good. I thought that whole short was really fluid, and the fight scenes were great. Like, the way he just fucking smashes the shit out of their fucking heads. I was like, oh my God.
Like, you could see why fucking Sonic and others keep him around. Mm-hmm. Like, it literally shows off, like, why he's such a capable Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't look like a dipshit like he did in Forces.
And that is very prominent. And that's very... This was very prominent throughout this whole entire, like, video.
Yeah.
So I can appreciate, like,
I was down for the whole thing, and I hope they do another short like this, because it really, like, all the shorts they do well. So I think they should just keep producing more. I hope more come out after the game.
And moving on from like Knuckles and whatnot, because the only two characters I can really talk about, really,
Sonic.
Well, not two, like the ensemble cast right now, from like Sonic, Amy, Tails, and Eggman.
Mm-hmm.
I want to talk about a little bit about Eggman, just from the little stuff that we got, and I'm mostly talking about the comic.
Yeah.
Like, you could tell Ian Flynn really loves writing for Eggman.
Yeah, it doesn't make him too goofy, you know? Like, he makes him smart.
Exactly. Yeah, he makes him an actual fucking scientist.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, kind of... It's so... Like, I love how he respects them and, like, where they came from and what they do. Because, like, his whole, like, conversation dialogue from, like, Orbot to, like, you know... Or about the Cuba, you know, they're goofballs, so like that's whatever.
Well, you know what I'm
right now
about?
Once again,
they're not in this game.
Hmm.
Orbot and Cuba.
Oh yeah. Oh,
and I was like, yeah. Fuck yes. I was like, get these motherfuckers out of here, bro.
Yeah, I love how they really did put them on the back burner and whatnot.
Yeah, I'm excited for that too. I'm glad it's not gonna be Goofy. That's all that boils down to. But Roger. Mr. Roger Craig Smith.
Hmm.
Think about his new Sonic.
You know what's funny, actually? His voice direction.
Yeah.
Like, and this goes for Lily from all of them, what I've heard so far. So, Roger, particularly the big blue elephant in the room, I feel like he's had the most, from what I've seen, I don't know if you have, the most maybe controversial, like, take. And the thing is, like, you know, some people like it, some people don't like it. Me personally, I actually think this might be his breakout game.
Yeah.
Like,
I think this might be his best Sonic performance. I think these other games didn't give him a chance.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So from what I've seen, I like it. I still don't know if I'm going to use the Japanese voice or not. I'm still on the fence because, again, he's been voicing Sonic since Adventure. So I'm still debating that in my head. But I might give Roger a chance and play the game with him.
Yeah, because I think we heard his voice at Tokyo Game Show, if I'm not mistaken. Like,
yes.
When the opening cinematic where he's, like, waking up and, like, all disgruntled and startled about what's going on and where's Amy and Tails is at. Yeah, so I would say right now, like, I like what I hear, and I think it's a much more mature direction that they're going for right now. And it's the same way how I feel like how Jason did in Unleashed.
Yeah, he definitely brought Sonic to a more mature level in Unleashed and Black Knight, so... Roger's definitely hitting that point in his Sonic career.
So, at Devin Mack, I'm really liking what I'm hearing from him. Literally. And, of course, like, you know, he's the second black actor to play Sonic other than Jaleel White. So, like, you know, gotta support that.
Yes, sir.
So,
and he's doing a phenomenal job. Like, I love this voice in the Prime, like, all the Prime trailers. Dude, I'm down for it. I fucking love it.
Oh,
it's a mixture of everything.
I do too. Like, I think he's capturing what we know from Sonic and
yes,
whatnot.
That cocky attitude,
snarkiness. Yes, his sporadic energetic attitudes, his spunkiness, snarkiness. And I don't know if you saw, like, the Sonic Prime, the recent trailer that dropped.
Yeah,
where it kind of told this. I won't lie, I think Eggman's voice is really, really, really good.
Yeah.
Because
it's one of those things where if they replaced the current cast, I wouldn't be mad. You know?
Exactly. And I haven't heard all of them yet so far, but from what I've heard from Sonic and Eggman, if they did replace them permanently with these guys, yeah, I wouldn't be mad.
Yeah.
Because I think they have, like, a nice... And people say that Devin sounds like a younger Roger. Me personally, I don't hear that.
Well, I heard it in the first trailer, but this newest one, I've heard more of his voice, and it sounds like his own thing. Like, in this newer trailer, now that I've heard more of it, his voice in a longer sentence than just 5 seconds, you can start to hear his own voice in it, and it's like, yeah, I think this is really good and fitting for Sonic.
Oh, yeah, most definitely, my friend.
And then I didn't even think we were going to talk about Prime. But we snuck it in.
So there you go. Like, if you want to, you can cut up the video and, like, just do a little bit of a synopsis on Prime. Which we could talk about, like, when December rolls more around before the release.
Yeah, if we get another trailer, then we can do another video about Prime specifically. Because I'm excited for that. Next month is going to be amazing for Netflix. They're going to get a lot of Sonic fans pouring in. New subscriptions. Oh, yeah, and then dude. After the series is over, everybody unsubscribes.
Or just find the joint account and whatnot, yes, even though exactly. Netflix is trying their fucking hardest to charge people for sharing passwords and
I know.
Shit. Get out of here. Fucking oh my bullshit. God.
So the next thing, the Showdown trailer.
So can we first talk about the first shot of Sonic? Like, well, how we see?
Dude.
Is it just... Was it you that told me this?
I did. Or, the Black Knight.
Yes. Okay, it was you. Because I thought I was bugging. Because I was like, yo, this
dude
has to be like...
The CG is like on par. And I was like, oh my fucking God. This shit is coming back. And I'm all for it. Bring this shit, put it on my plate, and I'm fucking going to gobble this shit up. That's how I feel about it. I was so fucking happy.
Oh my gosh. I have to say, like... From the shot to shot, from the just talking about the CGI alone for the trailer and whatnot, I really think like this trailer told me something that I haven't felt in a long time since I would say. Now it's not on par with Sonic Unleashed's opening cinematic or its cinematics in general, like, but it told me that hey guys, we know you love Sonic and so do we. That's what I got from that trailer.
Yeah, that's what I felt too. It's like, this is what you guys wanted. Here it is. That epic CG, you know, it looks like it's from the 2000s and I fucking love it, dude. That's where I fell in love with the series, and that Sonic and all that shit is where my roots are with this series. And then, you know, this whole past decade of all this crap that they've been putting in their games, you know,
shout out to Pontac and Graf.
Yeah, but you know, finally bringing us back to these roots, I'm so fucking happy.
It looks fucking like really great. Like I like from the fight choreography to like, you know, Sonic smile, like from the freaking voice over from the freaking, I don't even know, like the mystery voice and whatnot, talking about, you know, find the Chaos Emerald, destroy the Titans, you are the key, like all that shit, like it was just building it up more and more, and I was just like, bruh, until we finally got the first Titan from all the trailers and fucking Sonic turning into Super Sonic and just that clash, bruh, like I'm like, and that's how you make a launch trailer. That's yes. It I don't Dude, need to see anything else.
Watching that and like the little gameplay snippets and whatever in between, just that whole trailer with the I'm here music playing in the background, that rock, it felt like this game is a fucking game that you're trying to sell. It's not like Forces where they were kind of half-assing it. It feels like they are trying to sell you a game that you will play and enjoy.
Speaking of the snippets of gameplay we got, like, let's talk about like those final previews and people's initial final thoughts of the game.
You're talking about the IGN when they
went on that great from IGN, from GameSpot to freaking Shark. Actually, I got more of my information from Shaq News than anything else.
Shaq News,
because their interviews and whatnot.
These guys, yeah, their gameplay and shit.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Okay, yeah, I've seen their videos. The gameplay looks great. I think the level design for these cyberspace levels look good. I love that they reused Skyrail. That like it's, it's like what, 3 minutes long?
Yeah, because I think that was one of the people's initial like problems with the length of the cyberspace level. They said they were like just bite-sized pieces, like
yes,
under like maybe a minute long and whatnot. And it's just like that was like one, like probably the only thing that's been criticized and whatnot, which is crazy because that's supposed to be the traditional boost gameplay Sonic design levels and whatnot that everybody's accustomed to at this point.
Yeah,
but you know, I kind of digress. But when I saw that particular gameplay and whatnot, I was like, okay, so there's much more than what meets the eye. And I remember seeing during that Showdown trailer, going back to that, was Sonic and Chemical Plant riding on a fucking board?
Yes, he was.
I was like, wait, what the hell? I'm not gonna lie, kid. I was I kind of like, yo, they're bringing back fucking what? Stop it. Well, I don't lie. I kind of got giddy over that. Just a little stuff like
just the, that. Yeah, like, I saw that little snippet of in the footage and I was like, damn, bro, that looks fucking sweet. And then him riding that fish, I was like, God damn. Dude.
And I'm like, yo, and these are like the guardians and whatnot of these like islands and whatnot. Like, dude, bro, like, cause we already saw like freaking Asura, the tower, the ninjas and whatnot. And then just Ares Island with the freaking, that sumo boss with the freaking, what do you call it? The ring, like where he has to bounce off.
Oh, where you're bouncing off the walls.
And just like, you know, oh, absolutely. Like, that I'm like, oh, so that's where they got that from the fucking movie. So I was like, okay, you know, I can rock with that shit. Okay, I see you, Sonic Team. That was cool. But I think the fish one so far, outside the sumo one, was like kind of like my favorite one. I didn't see the full boss fight of it as
either.
Of yet.
I just saw that little clip, but like, and I was like, that looks really fucking fun.
It kind of makes me wonder, like, if this is what the future or the evolution of Sonic is gonna be. And it's getting this much positive response. Now, the game hasn't fully come out, so, like, anything could happen. Yeah. But so far, what I'm hearing and seeing and whatnot, if this is what the foundation's going to be is, then I'm all for it. So, as of right now, because when me and Chris, because I'm doing a live stream. I'm doing 100% hard playthrough of the game. I'm doing every nook and cranny, find every secret I can find. 100%ing all the islands and whatnot, and after that we'll come back to each other, like, and we'll talk about our review and give it a score, and that will be how we are rating our Sonic games.
Yeah.
But as of right now, from everything I've seen, I am very hopeful. I am very happy from everything I've seen, from the gameplay itself first and foremost, the absolute story, the characterization of each character. I feel like each actor is finally getting their chance to shine and actually prove that they actually can hold these characters to a candle and a high standard, especially for Roger, because I rag on Roger a lot, bro.
Yeah.
I really have, but I feel like, once again, this might be his breakout game, and I'm really excited to see what he does. And I'm just, I'm actually more hopeful for at least Sonic's future in the games and whatnot.
Yeah.
And I don't need this game to be a 10 out of 10. I really don't. I just want to have a good, fun experience.
And I think that's a good way to summarize that. Like, it's hopeful, and it doesn't need to be a 10 out of 10 in my book. It just needs to be fun. I'm not looking for a masterpiece. I'm just looking for a good time.
Yes.
That's what, like, I say when I go in the strip club. Not looking for a masterpiece.
Yeah.
I'm looking for a fun time, all right?
Yeah, I'm not here for a long time. I'm here for, like, a good time. You know what I'm saying? but with that being said, after this game, when the reviews come out, when we do our review and whatnot, and we'll come back to this topic, I really do feel like this is Sonic's year. Dude,
oh, yeah.
We had the second movie was a fucking banger.
We had Ugly Sonic.
Job. We got Ugly Sonic, and regardless how you feel about Sonic Origins at this point, that game did come out.
Yeah.
Sonic's comic book run, they got all the way up past issue 50, which was my favorite issue. They were really killing it. Ian Flynn, Evan Stanley have been really killing it on that front. I'm so happy that they're continuing it. Now we have this game, and after that, we have a whole brand new TV show that we haven't gotten in like 2 decades.
Yeah.
Like,
well, I mean, we had Boom, but
I'm talking about actually. Okay, I know. Let me retract that back. But I'm talking about
mainline, not.
Yeah, mainline,
side
more
series.
Modern Sonic.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I was saying. Thank you. But like, yeah, it's just been. This might just be the year for Sonic. Yeah, all the Sonic fans out there, I know y'all eating good, man.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
So, like, I'm happy to be part of that. And as a Sonic fan, and like, it's just like, you know.
Sonic fans will always get a bad rap because, of course, we got the cringe lords.
The cringy, the cringe lords, the deviant art and whatnot. And what.
But if you ignore them, I think you got a pretty solid community.
Yeah. Like people like us. I mean, like, sure, like, there's times we could be like, not, I would say, on the level of cringe and whatnot. Like, we'll crack a corny joke here and there, but, like, still.
Well, I guess, yeah, I mean, we do fall sort of into the cringe category sometimes. I'm not going to deny it. I'm pretty cringe half the time, you know? That's not something I can deny. But I'm content with it, and I'm fine with it. I think it's good cringe, not, like, where you raise your nose all the way up to your fucking eyes and go, ugh. Yeah. God, what am I watching right now? I think we're excited, and I'll be playing the series when it comes out. I'll be recording it all in one day. I don't think I'm gonna 100% it like Chris is over here. If you want to see that, go over to his Twitch. It's gonna be in the description. But I will be playing it and having a fun time, and we'll make it to the end boss and complete the game that way.
And then expect us to come back maybe a week or two after we beat the game and whatnot. And we'll tell you guys our final thoughts about it, which I'm very excited about.
Sit here and gush over the game or bash it for being terrible.
Oh, absolutely. But like I said, like, I'm still hopeful. I'm like, especially what come and whatever happens next with the Blue Boar, whether good or bad, like, I know I'm going to be there.
Yeah, we're stuck in it. You know, once you get started in it, there's no leaving. All right, guys.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for watching us talk about this. You know, we had a lot of fun doing it. And again,
yes, absolutely.
Make sure to check out Chris's stuff in the description. And I will see you guys in the next video, which will be Sonic Frontiers.
Take care.
Bye.